stand in front of a Roderick O'Connor, you are almost made to feel as if you are in the painting itself, and can almost reach out and touch the items displayed. That is the skill of the artist. O'Connor was a wonderfully atmospheric painter. Here, the apples on the plate are like a Cézanne painting, and that is no surprise, as O'Connor was very much a part of the art scene in France at the end of the 19th and early 20th centuries. He was close to Paul Gauguin and immersed himself in the modern art movement of that time. O'Connor was a man of wealth and was lucky enough not to have to rely on sales of his work to survive. Interestingly, Gauguin once held an exhibition of his works to fund a trip to the Polynesians, but only sold one painting. It was bought by Roderick O'Connor. Despite appearing to use a more traditional subject matter, O'Connor was very much a modernist. Through portraiture, landscape, and still life, from the 1890s period in Pont-Aven through to his Paris studio when this picture was painted, O'Connor stayed true to his traditions, cleverly modernized them, bringing the picture to life with the use of these wonderful fauvist greens, reds, and blues, while the light and shading coming across the canvas from the window transport you into the Paris studio in Montparnasse. The tactile folding fabric, front and back, give the picture an added flow. The best O'Connors always portray a feeling that they were painted for exhibition. As if dressed up, they want to be seen. And at a generous size of approximately 28 by 24 inches, this work doesn't disappoint in any way.